Hello everybody, this is Dr. Weird. Welcome back to Let's Play Gothic 2, Night of the Raven. So, right now we're gonna go through the woods, up to the Sekops farm, kill as many beasts as we can to get as many, much experience as we can. So, this is gonna probably take a while, so it's better just to fast forward it. So, enjoy the show. Nothing there. Inside this cave is the witch I was talking about, and she can heal us. She will also give us a quest.
All by yourself out here?
Tell me what you want of me, and then go away! I'm busy!
She's busy staring at the fire.
Can you heal me?
That's what you came for, isn't it? Just let me know when there's something wrong with you.
What are you doing out here?
I've been living here for as long as I can remember, attending to my herbs. The forest is my friend. It offers me all that I need.
Who are you?
You haven't heard of me, then. Herb witch, they say. Quack, they call me. But when they're in a bad way, they all suddenly remember good old Sagitta and her healing herbs.
Heal me.
Let me see. My ointment will take care of the worst of your wounds.
Can you teach me your herbal lore?
How interesting. I don't get asked that very often. So you want to be my student? Then you'll first have to prove your request is serious. At the moment, I am working on a very rare potion made from exquisite herbs and juices. If you can get me one ingredient, a very rare herb, which I don't have here, I shall train you.
Where can I find this ingredient?
The herb I require only grows in places where it can get all the nutrients it needs. These are found in the excrements of a black troll. That's why it's so difficult for me to get the herb, you see?
What ingredient is that?
It's an extremely rare plant, an herb called sun aloe. You can recognize it by its intensive almond scent.
Let's see if I can get hold of it somewhere.
Well then, good luck with your search.
What wares do you have to offer?
Tell me what you want.
Well, she has a couple of recipes. Wait, careful, Hunt. Southern Islands. I'll sell this stuff. One-handed, I don't need this. One-handed, don't need this. Staff mace, 70, 70. This is... Sell. Woodcutter's axe. Oh, two-handed. 50. Man, where did I get all these branches? Fireball. Should I sell this? I'll just keep it for a little while longer. Might become useful. Don't need the leather armor anymore. What ring is this? Oh yeah. Skeleton bones, goblin bones. Sell all of that crap. One before, I'm gonna keep this. Silver ring, sulfur. Man, I'm rich. I'm becoming more and more rich. Plus, when I get all the hides, I mean, when I give all the hides to Bosper, which I've gotten so far, is gonna make me extremely rich. I don't really know if I'm gonna need all that money. Actually, becoming a mercenary, I mean, choosing the mercenary path requires the most gold. You will see during the gameplay. If you want to become a mage, it requires 1,000 gold and a sheep, which is 100 gold, so 1,100 gold. It's not that much, actually. It's easy to get, and if you want to be a militia, it doesn't require any gold at all. Okay, those bandits should be somewhere around here, because right now we are behind Sackup's farm. Yes. Let's just kill these. Okay, so, anywho, bandits are back there. I'm gonna go there in a sec. First, I'm gonna go and ask around if there's any problems in here.
Hey, you! Well, kiddo?
That's no way for a farmhand to talk to me. Just how often do I have to remind you?
I'm not a field hand.
And what do you want here? We have nothing, so you can just leave right now.
So what do you do when you're not busy playing ruler of the farm?
Stand guard. The filthy militiamen from the city are coming onto our land more and more often and stealing everything they can get their hands on. Only last week the bastards were here, and they took some of our sheep. If I could get my hands on one of them, I'd make short work of him.
But of course. Why don't the mercenaries help you against the militia?
Before they even turn up, I've already driven them off.
Is that how you always treat your field workers?
Of course, they need that. Whoever doesn't toe the line here gets thrashed. That's the way it goes.
I need to talk to your father.
He hasn't got time, but I'm his deputy. What can I help you with?
By introducing me to your father.
You're a real tough guy and a good fighter, huh?
The best.
I think maybe I better get him then.
Never mind, boy. I'll find him, I'm sure.
If you say so.
See that guy standing guard over there? Actually, let's talk to this guy first.
Hey. How are things?
Ah, a new face here on the farm. Has the old skinflint finally granted me an apprentice?
I'm not an apprentice.
Oh, I see. I'm not as young as I used to be, you know, and I've been waiting for a replacement for years. You aren't here because the neighbors are annoyed, are you?
Have you seen any bandits passing through here?
I certainly have. They passed along the edge of the field near Sekob's farm and entered the forest to the north. They were carrying loads of weapons. They looked like they were all set to win the war against the orcs. If my eyes didn't deceive me, they were also dragging a young woman along to the forest. I really hope they left her alone. I'm just glad they stayed away from our farm.
What's the work you do here?
Oh, I guard the sheep, and I've been doing that for as long as I can remember. The animals are very loyal and very smart, you see. If you treat them well, they'll follow you for a lifetime.
What's the trouble with your neighbors?
The grass on this side of the big field is always so stunted and dry, so I mostly go to the big pastures of the other farmers. Ooh, the landowner doesn't mind, but Bengar, the farmer on the high pastures, always makes a big deal out of it when I take the animals up there. He says Sekob should pay if I take his animals on to Bengar's pasture. But Sekob won't spend a measly coin for that, so I can't go up onto the plateau anymore.
Maybe I should talk to Bengar.
You do that for me? What will you tell him? I mean, I don't want any trouble, you hear?
We'll see about that.
Okay, let's talk to this guy over here. Bronco, I think his name is. Bam.
So where are we headed then?
Are you the foreman here?
If you want to go ambling across my land, you'll pay me 5 gold coins, or you're in for a good thrashing.
Forget it. You won't get anything from me.
Then I'm afraid I'm gonna have to tan your hide.
Come on and try it, then.
Well, in that case...
Thank you.
Easy. Is his weapon better? Probably not. Oh, it is! No, it's not. Mine's better. It requires less strength for same amount of damage.
Hey, you! There's this guy who demands a toll from every passerby, claiming he's the farmer.
Yes, I know. That's Bronco. He does whatever he wants. Not that I haven't pounded it into him 1,000 times that he should finally get back to work.
But?
He just doesn't do it. My father's quite annoyed with me that I still haven't managed to persuade him to go back to work.
Maybe I can help you.
Do you mean that? Okay, listen. If you can get Bronco to go back to work, I'll pay you, shall we say, 10 gold pieces? What do you say?
If you demand more, he will say okay, but...
All right, I'll see what I can do.
But hurry up about it.
But he doesn't really have that money, so you will be empty. You will finish empty-handed.
So, still got that big mouth?
You're a mercenary, aren't you? I might have known. Don't beat me, please! I'll even go back to work, okay?
Bam. 3,000. Well, 250. 2,500.
Hey, you! Bronco's back at work.
Really? That's terrific.
Yeah, and now I want my cash.
Well, business is business, right?
Cool. Let's ask this guy in here if he has anything smart to tell us.
What are you doing on my land? There's nothing here to steal clear off.
Isn't there a piece of land in this blasted country that doesn't belong to anyone?
Go to work. Then maybe someday you can call a piece of land your own. But until then, kindly loaf around somewhere else.
Listen.
I don't have any work for you at the moment. Now go.
Guess not. What about your wife? Really?
Hey, you! Everything all right with you?
Well, it's so-so. My back hurts from all this hard labor. What are you doing here? I don't get visitors here all that often. Usually it's either some cutthroats from the mountains or those horrible malicious soldiers from the city. They've been raiding our farm rather frequently lately. But you don't look like you're one of them, or are you?
What are you doing here?
I've been asking myself that for several years. Sekab, my husband, has fallen out with everyone in the area by now. He's in debt everywhere, and so he steals goods from Onar's stocks and sells them in town. By now, he's accumulated a fortune with his underhanded dealings, and he works our field hands until their backs break. His own people call him nothing but slave driver these days. I'm not particularly proud to call myself the wife of Sekab. Believe me, sometimes I wish the barrier were still in place. Would you like to buy something to eat? Or perhaps something for hunting in the forest?
Why did the militia attack you on your farms here?
Because there's nobody there to prevent them from simply plundering our farms instead of buying our goods. The king is far away, and we just have to put up with working for Onar and hoping that Onar will send help when we really need it.
What does Onar's help look like?
Sometimes we receive warning in advance when some militiamen are planning to pay us a visit on their own account to rob us. Then we send somebody to the old landowner to ask him for help. And then usually, it doesn't take long for the mercenaries he pays to come here and chase off the militia. But when all is said and done, the mercenaries aren't much better.
Barrier?
Well, it's the dome that used to enclose the old Valley of Mines. Many of the farmers and workers who committed a crime back then were simply tossed in there, and they never came back.
Have you ever been at the barrier?
No, we only heard about it. Bengar, the farmer on the high pastures, can surely tell you more about that. His farm is quite close to the pass which leads to the Valley of Mines.
Keep your chin up.
Take care of yourself and don't let them get to you.
Okay, let's go get those bandits. There are also a couple of wargs in this forest. I'm not sure I'm able to... Well, I'm pretty sure I'm not able to kick their asses, so I'm just gonna skip them and go straight for the bandits. So these are the bandits that took Lucy. I hope there are not a lot of them. Let's heal up a bit. Hmm, 20 more. If I get 20 more, oh shit, it's still not gonna be enough for mastering two-handed weapons. Okay, there they are.
I'm gonna rip you to pieces.
Oh shit. No, 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 this guy. Okay. Save it risky. Okay, get that guy. Oh shit. Cool. Oh. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Cool. Get him faster. Was I lucky right now, or am I so much stronger than when I was before? Don't know. Good. I didn't steal from this guy, didn't I? Did I? Semen. Okay. So, Lucy, I'm here for ya. Ooh. There are a lot of these. That thing said delivery. Ooh, Fernando, yay. Lucy. And she's not here. Well, shit. What? Lucy's farewell. Oh shit, they killed her. They killed the bitch. The whore. Lucy's farewell letter, where is it? I cannot find the words to describe the story I am. I know I will not understand where I come here. Oh, okay, she's not dead. She's just gone, probably voluntarily. To where, wherever they were taking the slaves. Okay, that's that. Man, there are a lot of these. How much do I need for a new level up? A lot. You know what? I will make my way back to the camp. I mean, to the town. Unless I have any other thing to do. I'll just fast forward. I'll fight the monsters on my way, so.
Hey!
traveling so far from home, out here you have to be careful, especially when you're all by yourself.
What are you doing out here?
Well, the tavern is too expensive for me. That's why I settled here. The previous inhabitants don't seem to need it anymore.
This guy is a hunter. He has a quest for us. This is where Bartok was talking about, where he hung out with his fellow hunters before he resigned.
Isn't it too dangerous out here?
Well, not if you can defend yourself. My crossbow has already proven to be of service many times.
It's not all that big.
But deadly, if you know how to handle it. I used to have a bigger one. Unfortunately, I lost it. I ventured too far north into the mountains. There's a big stone circle there with a sacrificial altar. While I was hunting scavengers up there, these vile undead beings came out of the woods and attacked me. All I could do was run for my life. While I was running, the crossbow slipped from my hand. I bet it's still lying up there by that strange stone circle in the north.
Who used to live in this camp?
No idea. Probably some hunters. I suppose it got too dangerous for them out here.
He can teach you crossbowing skills, and maybe also dexterity. I don't need either one of those, so let's just pick up the crap. Cool. Pick up these things.
I know nothing about picking locks.
I really need to go back. Yeah, I'll go back in town and learn. I'll learn the lockpicking skill. What? That quest, bottoms up, might be done by now. I don't know if it's been 2 days already. Let's go ahead and see.
Nothing to plunder.
Might as well kill. Huh, just one scavenger. Oh, no. What? I'll first talk to that guy. If the quest is done, then I'll go back to town, and on my way I'll kill people.
There you are, finally. I've been waiting for you.
What happened?
The drinking contest is finally over.
Who won?
This time Randolph has won. Rukar must have been having a bad day. So, well, I hope that was the last time. I don't want that kind of to-do in my house ever again, remember that.
Wait a minute. Hangover?
No, I feel fine, really. It finally worked this time. Thanks again for your money. Here, take it back. Looks like Rukar won't be getting up anytime soon.
He's already up. He's here.
You seem to have bitten off more than you can chew.
Here's your money, and not one word more.
Okay, I'll fast forward. So over there is monastery. There is no use going there right now because I wouldn't be able to enter anyways. And up here there was an altar with a priest in front of it. And the way this priest is useful, I mean, it's useful if you enter monastery. He also can sell you a few stuff, but he can also give you his blessing of Innos, for free if you don't pay for that guy in the marketplace to do it. So let's see if he has anything to do.
Innos be with you. What can I do for you, Wanderer?
Bless me.
I bless you in the name of Innos, May the Lord's fire burn in your heart and give you the strength to act according to his justice.
What are you doing here?
I am a magician of fire, a priest of our god, Innos. This shrine is consecrated to him, the highest god, the creator of the fire and lord of justice. People come to me in order to pray to Innos and be blessed. And for a small donation, you can get many useful things from me.
Donation? It's called trading.
Show me your wares.
Don't need this. Although, hit point bonus, it's not bad, but it's expensive.
Where will this path take me?
The path leads to the Monastery of the Magicians of Fire. However, access is permitted only to the servants of Innos. Since you have already chosen to join another group, entrance will be denied you.
See?
May Innos watch over you always.
Anyway, I'll go back to the town now, and I'll fast forward it. There we go, we're back at a city. So I hope you guys enjoyed all that hunting I just did. And I'll see you guys in the next video. So take care and bye bye.